you know what? You got to pray and continue to pray. The Bible says pray without ceasing.
Amen.
You're like, well, Lord, I got to go to work. You can pray and go to work. Mm-hmm. Bless your name, God. Thank
yes,
you, Father.
Yes, Lord. Thank hallelujah.
You,
Lord.
You don't know what you're saying anyway. Matter of fact, strike up some prayer so somebody hey. Can ask. Let them ask me what I'm doing. You know, yes, open up, Lord. And the first thing my answer, they asked me.
Uh-huh.
I didn't provoke the conversation, but then I invited them in and some of the Holy Spirit. I want you to, that's one of the ways I got saved. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I didn't ask her, that sister, I've got to testify and give God glory for people that do pray on the job. Amen.
Amen.
Yes, because Lord. That sister would pray for me and oh, I couldn't stand her. If she always be out of cubicle, praise the Lord. I was like, my God. Heard it like that, she praised the Lord. Like what she want like that? Praise him, glory. She working on a docket, glory. I was like, my God. They cannot. I'm sitting there talking about it behind you when you deliver it. Because now, you know what? I laugh about it because bless now the I'm the one that does what she was doing. Somebody does some glory!
Hey, God! Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Praise God! If it wasn't meant for her prayers and her persistence, yeah, she gave yeah. God glory. Yeah. She gave God glory on my behalf.
Yeah,
if
yeah.
it wouldn't have been for her praying on the job,
yeah.
And all of a sudden, she'd keep leaving me scriptures. Every time I said, what? Every time, just running from the word. I said, not another Bible verse. So what you want? I kept doing. This is how I was. I went out. That's how I
yeah,
was.
Yeah.
But I'm here to tell you, those little nuggets
yes.
led me every. Because when I was going through my valley experience, and I needed somebody. Guess who I went to?
That's right.
That same person that
thank
was putting
you,
little nuggets, in, and she invited me to go to a lock-in.
Thank you, Father.
And I told her I couldn't go. I said I can't go. I got chores.
Yeah.
Excuses. Amen. You yeah. don't say chores. It's excuses. Amen. I can't go, and it's a Friday night. I have chores. I got some chores to do on a Friday night. My chores is busy. I got to do them chores. I got a certain time to get all my chores done. And surely enough, I found myself at that house because I was going through something.
Amen.
All of a sudden, those chores weren't as desperate as I needed the Lord.
Yes. Yeah.
And surely enough, I don't know how I made it, and I share that. I was sitting in the middle of a rows at a church, and it was a whole bunch of, you know, just a bunch of women. It was like a women's lock-in, and I was already wasn't good with crowds, you know. And so that bothered me really tremendously. But I'm sitting there in the middle of the row, and I don't know how I made it all the way to the front.
Wow.
To the altar.
Wow.
I don't know if I leaped over or if they parted wow. the Red Sea. I have no
wow.
idea. But I knew I was at that altar, and I knew that my life was changed.
Bless the Lord.
At that moment, I've never been the same woman again. That was back
thank
in the
you,
1990s.
Lord.
I give God glory
yes,
for that.
Lord. Yes,
I
Lord.
I had no idea what God was going to do. All of that. But I'm saying that to be encouraged because, you know what? That individual had a fixed mind. She was stable in her faith, even though I was refusing. So that means I'm trying to encourage some of you, because there are some individuals that just refuse to hear your words. They refuse to receive your prayer. There she go praying again. And then she want to lay that hand. Don't bring all. Don't bring the anointing all. Because when they bring the all, they figure what you cooking. They don't know that they're on the menu. They don't realize that they're on the menu. The Holy Spirit is frying them up, getting them ready for his work. I want you to understand that it took somebody to be fixed and firm and settled in their mind and saying that, you know what, that soul is coming in. Even though I was complaining. I'm trying to encourage some of you here tonight that the Lord God is saying that you be unmoved. She was fixed in her faith. And because she was fixed in her faith and knowing who God was, I was able to be fixed in my faith.
Yeah.
Because
yeah, yeah.
I'm here to tell
yeah,
you,
yeah.
I am the one. And it's amazing how God will have you to be what you used to complain to be.
Yeah.
He has a sense of humor.
You are the one that you complain. You are the one. So watch yourself. Those that you were complaining about before you got saved, watch out. Oh, my God. You're like, that's going to be me? Yes. The one,
oh,
the one that worked on your nerve the most.
Oh,
there she go.
That's the one you're going to be. You can't even say, people walk by, man. I pray for you. You have those people in your life, and you're like, Lord, all of a sudden, the ones you would say you were, all of a sudden you find yourself, you're going, is it all right if I pray for you? I don't want to know your name, I just want to pray for you. Lord. You become that same person that you were running away from. I'm almost done, but the Lord God wants you to know you got to be fixed. Your mind has got to be fixed. The Apostle Paul spoke, he said, immovable. Abounding in the work of in the work of the Lord, knowing that your labor is not in vain in the Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Come on now, knowing that your labor, all that you're doing, you gotta be fixing your mind. All that you're doing for God tonight, all that you're representing in your life, all that you're doing for your family tonight, be fixing your mind. Know that it's not in vain. God's not, the enemy's sitting back and wishing that you would not be here tonight, but we give God glory.
Yes, Lord.
You know why? Because you have a predetermined, I'm fixed. I'm not going anywhere. I'm going to be right where my daddy want me to be. I'm going to be under the fountain of blessing.
Lord. Yes,
under
Lord.
The fountain, Lord God, under the fountain. I'm going to get everything. I'm not going to miss not a nugget, not a sample, not a crumb tonight. I'm going to get it all because my mind is fixed in the name of Jesus. I know that my faith is going to be strong in the Lord. Why? Because I'm in the power of his might. It's not in my own strength that I can stand here. You must understand that, people of God, we must learn how to just be fixed. Say your neighbor, I'm fixed.
I'm fixed.
In the name of Jesus, your neighbor on the side, I'm fixed.
I'm fixed.
And as I'm going to close tonight, you must understand that you got to have that hope and that anchor. I'm closing with Hebrews 6:19. The word of the Lord God says that when you have hope, that is your anchor.
Yes, Lord. Yes, it is.
You got to be anchored. You got that's your hope. Hebrews 6:19. When you're anchored, it allows you to enter into the presence and go behind the veil. You know, it's one thing to be in the holy place. Another thing to be in the holies of holies.
Come on.
But there's another thing to go behind the veil.
Come on, Pastor.
When you go behind the veil, the only thing that's there is the mercy seat.
Come on.
And on the mercy seat, you know what sits there? The word.
Yeah.
The word sits in there. And that's why whenever you're praying for someone, really, when you really want to pray for them, bring them on the mercy seat. Go behind the veil. Put them in the word, and then just back off. Say, there you go, God. That's right there. But see, when your mind is fixed like that, that means no matter what happens, that the Lord God is so, that you are so positive to know that I am entering the presence where I can go behind the veil. I don't know about you, but my desire is to go behind the veil. I don't want to just stand on the outside. I want to get behind the veil because I know when my mind gets fixed, that's in Hebrews 6:19, that your hope would be that anchor of your soul which allows you to enter the presence which is behind the veil. The Lord God says, my sons and my daughters, I want you to know that your mind must be fixed tonight. And you've got to be steadfast in your dealings, unwavering, that you not be tossed back and forth, that you should not be moving here and there and going everywhere, that you need to be, I have a made up mind that I'm not going to quit this time. I may have put my hand to the plow and done some things, but this time I'm not going to quit. I'm not going to walk out of my marriage. I'm not going to walk out of my friendship. I'm not going to walk out of my relationship. I'm not going to walk out on that job. Not this time. Not this year. Not this year.
My God.
Oh, thank you, Lord God. I'm not going to walk out on my family. Come on now. Not this time. Not this time. Yeah. Things may be happening and things may be going wrong. I'm not going to walk out on my church. Come on now. I'm not going nowhere. It's a word of encouragement. I'm not going nowhere. My daddy don't tell me, I ain't going nowhere.
That's it. You're hating that up.
I'm grounded. Why? Because I know when the blessing's going to start overflowing, that I'm going to get in on it. Why? Because I am rooted. He said, if you abide in me, I abide in you.
Lord.
Ask what you will, and it shall be given unto thee. I want you to know that there's a principle to the matter of that. And you can ask what you will, but you got to be connected to get that. I'm a naming and claiming it, blaming and shaming. Now wait a minute. You got to abide. That means you got to be connected. That means you got to be steadfast. That means you can't be going everywhere. That means you know I'm gonna stay right here, God. I'm not going to move until you bless me.
Lord God.
I'm not going nowhere. Lord God, I know that you're my healer. I know that you're my deliverer. I know that you're somebody. So, Lord God, I'm going to be right here. I'm not going to move, Lord God. I may be driving to my house, but Lord God, I'm sitting right here in your presence.
Yeah, yeah, Lord.
Because I know that you're well able to do exceeding and abundant above all I can ask or think. I want you to know that you've got to be predetermined in your mind, people of God. As I said, I'm closing tonight. You must be predetermined in your mind that you're not going anywhere. That you are so fixed in God. You're so in love with God that you're not going to be easily persuaded. My God, Lord, help the body of Christ.
Hey.
When we're so easily persuaded. Yes. Lord God, pray for it. Lord God, the body of Christ. That Lord God, that we're running after everything and we're missing out on God. Mm. That Lord God, we've got to understand there's a principle to get what you desire from God. Woo. It's not just, well, I'm going to just pass by. No, you got to be rooted. You, I told you, that's nothing but a prophetic word. Yes. The Lord God, in order for you to get in on it, you got to get in on it. Mm. My God, if you want a blessing, you want the threefold blessing to overflow upon you and your family and your child, then that means you got to get in on it. You can't just sit back on the sidelines and just watch everybody else because you're going to miss your miracle.
Amen.
My God, the Lord God said it's time for you to get involved.
Yes, Lord.
Ooh,
yes,
Lord. And be faithful when you do it. Thank you, Lord God. I'm here to tell you that's why some of there's going to be some individuals in here that's going to pass you up.
Jesus.
Out your name, man.
Jesus.
There's going to be some individuals that pass you up. Why? Because they know how to remain faithful.
Amen. Amen.
They're not, they're fixed.
Amen.
They're like, well, wait a minute. I believe just what my daddy tells me.
Yes, Lord.
I got a made up mind. I'm predetermined. I'm fixed.
Amen.
You can do what you want. This is not Burger King. You can have it your way.
Yes, Lord.
If you want it Burger King, wait, go to Burger King. We're not Burger King over here. We worship the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords.
Hey, hallelujah.
That King.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Thank you, Lord God. It's not like that over here.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord God. That you know what? That my labor is not in vain.
That's right.
Some things you've got to travail for.
Mm.
Lord God, you're wanting it to just be served on a platter like a golden. Some things you got to travail for.
That's right.
You got to
that's
cry right. out for. And the Lord God says, he said, but that's how you remain steadfast and fixed.
Lord.
That my mind is made up, O people of God, as I close tonight. As I said for the final time, in the name of Jesus, you've got to have a made up mind. You've got to be steadfast in your dealings. You've got to not allow anybody to stop you, distract you, move you, uproot you, because you know what? They're trying to move you out of your place.
Yeah.
My Lord God says, I have you where you need to be.
Hey.
Right underneath the fountain.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Right underneath the fountain. Thank you, Lord God. Right underneath the fountain. The Lord God says, the fountain that flows. Hallelujah. And you say, well, it hasn't happened yet, but hold on. Though it tarries, wait.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Lord God. God said you got to be fixed. You got to be fixed.
Yes, Lord.
Because, yes, in Habakkuk it says it's for an appointed time.
Amen.
Mm.
That means it's going to be the right time.
Yeah,
thank you, Lord.
Lord.
Not going to be before your time. It's not going to be after your time.
All right.
It's going to be in your season.
Thank you, Lord.
Hey.
In your season. Like, wait a minute. My season? Yes.
Yes.
We all have a season. Come on, give God some glory. And Lord God, I'm going to pray this prayer because we're fixed. We're steadfast. We're not going anywhere. Our mind's made up. Thank you, Lord God. We got a made up mind. Come on, lift up your hands for the blessing as I seal you tonight. Father God, as I seal this word over your sons and your daughters, your kings and your queens, that Father God, that they have a made up mind. They're predetermined in their mind that they're fixed in the name of Jesus, that they will be steadfast. Lord God, though the storms may come and things may occur in their life, that Lord God, that they're going to remain faithful unto you, Lord God. They'll remain loyal unto you. Lord God, as I seal this word upon these kings and queens in the wonderful name of Jesus. Now, Father God, as I'm praying for traveling grace and mercy on the highways and byways, when they get to their homes and destination, that everything will be decent and in order. We said amen.
Amen.
Amen.